The Warzone Season 4 Reloaded update has brought a lot of weapon balance in with it, and that includes nerfs to the Blixen, the Armaguerra, and the Marco. Now, these SMGs were the three meta SMGs everyone's been using in recent times. With these SMGs now being nerfed, I'm wondering whether or not a new SMG is going to rise to the top of the meta, and I'm putting my money on the Vanguard PPSH. The PPSH has an incredible fire rate, which not only means you can down enemies super quickly, but it's also very forgiving if you happen to miss a few shots. Couple that with really manageable recoil, and this is an incredible SMG to use on Rebirth Island. And you're going to see that in the gameplay, where I also provide commentary on what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, as I try to improve as a player, and hopefully that'll help a few of you do the same. So if you want to know if these weapons are the next meta, or you just want to improve as a player, consider sticking around, and maybe even like the video and subscribe for more. So let's get into it. Okay, so obviously you want to be able to grab your loadie as soon as possible. It's going to give you a massive advantage over those that are still using ground loot weapons. I also like to try and get down an ammo box as soon as I can after getting loaded. That way, not only do you have maximum ammo when you're starting, you also have maximum tacticals as well. Luckily enough, we also managed to get a UAV pretty early, so that's going to give us a good idea of where all the opposition players are so that we can start pushing straight away. God damn.
Head of Campion EPS. The enemy team is tracking
your location. So luckily enough, the occupation scan revealed that there's a guy just on the road next to the building, so I pushed the window to see whether or not I could get a shot off at him. Unfortunately not, because the wall's in the way, but on the minimap, the occupation scan does show that there's a guy in tower building, so I decided to push that way, and luckily enough, he decides to push me and I get an easy kill. Unfortunately, his teammate decides to take a few shots at me and removes a plate and a half of health. I decide to try and dip out so that I can plate up and get back to full health. As he decides not to push me that aggressively, I decide to stay and wait for him to push so that I should be able to get the kill. Thankfully, my audio is pretty decent and I hear his footsteps on the roof, and I know that he's decided to push the window. On the enemy's team. Once again, I can hear footsteps around me, but I'm not sure exactly where they're coming from, so I decide to dip out, reposition and approach the area again, so hopefully I can catch them off guard. As I'm doing so, I can hear an enemy landing in. Because of where it is, I assume it's the guy that I killed earlier landing back on his gear, and I decide to push that area and get the easy kill. Once again, the footstep audio tells me that I'm being pushed, and a little bit of movement helps me get that kill. On the enemy's tail. Move to the target area. You don't have all day. Here, combat scout really comes in clutch.
One down.
With my initial shot, I managed to tag the player, which allows me to see him through the wall. That makes finishing him off all that much easier. Here I made a real error. I didn't check the minimap, so I didn't know about the enemy right behind me. Unfortunately, he manages to land a few shots, but I do manage to get away. My priority here is to get away with the stim, regain my health, and replate. But then I come across an enemy that clearly doesn't know I'm there, so I decide to go for the kill. I'm rudely interrupted, however, by the guy on top of prison roof, and then I just need to get into cover. Thankfully, he seems to give up on trying to kill me, and I manage to get away. I didn't expect the strike to hit me through the building, and unfortunately it does, so then my priority again is regaining health. Once I've regained health and I've plated, I check the minimap and I can see that there's fighting going on in Grandma's house, so that's where I'm pushing next. When the grenade comes into the building, that makes me think they know where I am and that they're pushing, so I decide to reposition to tower building. Unfortunately, as I'm repositioning, I get shot in the back, which takes off most of my plates, so now I have to play really careful until I can manage the plate up. Losing ground. Move it. Because I'm so low on plates, I decide to push tower and get a good idea of where everyone is. Luckily enough, I find one plate and I get the circle pull. I notice an enemy team buying a loadout on my right. I know that they're going to be pushing it, so I make sure to keep an eye on it. Luckily enough, I do manage to catch one of them going for it, and I wait for him to get out in the open before I start shooting. This allows me to get a nice easy kill. I decided to check to see whether or not the guy just downed his guy in the armor, and luckily enough he does. So I managed to plate up and now I'm back to full health. I can re-engage bikes with confidence. At this point I realise that my team's slightly split and all the fighting seems to be happening in Grandma's house. It doesn't make sense for me to push that alone because I'll be massively outnumbered. So I decided to take the tower again, which is the power position, and let the situation develop. Luckily we get the circle pull our way again and it becomes a 4v1 situation in our favour. I hear some footsteps to my right, and because I've got the power position, the final kill is a nice easy one and we get the win.
Where are you?
Okay, so landing in, you're not always going to have loadout guns to fight with. Sometimes you're going to have to pick up whatever you've got to hand and give it a go. Here, luckily enough, I've got a green NZ and a green Blixen. I managed to get a few knocks on the first guy, but he manages to get away, and I managed to down the next enemy with the Blixen. Here's a great example of why you should always pick up a tactical, even if it's not the one that you'd normally run. I don't normally run grenades, but I managed to use one that I found on the ground to get a down. This is a great example of playing patiently. I could have pushed the roof and challenged that guy, but I don't know how many of his teammates were up there. Without having any information, I decided to back off, make sure I was fully reloaded and fully plated, and then use the airstrike to cause confusion. Then we can use that confusion to push the roof and hopefully create an advantage. When pushing the roof, I missed my initial shots at this guy. Because I missed my shots, I decided to dip out and try and reset the fight. As nobody likes letting a kill get away, this guy decides to push me and I let him. That makes getting the kill very easy.
Marked an AR. On the enemy's tail.
I managed to get the down and wanted to go for the first. Unfortunately, I didn't see the sniper waiting on the water tower. He manages to down me. Fortunately enough, I get into cover and get the revive. I see a team on the roof of Nova and I decide to engage. I manage to tag a couple but don't get any downs. As I push, I hear a player landing in behind me.
Enemy dropping into the AO.
I notice this guy going for his loadout.
On the enemy's tail.
I manage to land my shots and get the kill. Because I don't have any up-to-date information, I decide to head back to the roof of prison, which is the power position for this circle. Right here, I notice that there's an enemy player on the top of the water tower. Because of the distance, I decide to mount on the wall. This gives me that extra accuracy to make sure that I'm landing my shots and get the down. The down I got on the water tower finally dies and I get the ping for his teammates. It shows that there are a couple of enemies pushing from camp. The window from the top floor of prison gives me a great vantage spot to be able to take advantage of this.
An enemy team is hunting you.
Now I'm actually trying to plate up while also not letting the enemies get away. Luckily enough, I managed to get my two plates on and then I managed to down one of the players as they're running across open ground. This causes a bit of confusion as the other guy doesn't seem to know where the first guy got down from. That gives me the chance to down him as well. So at this point we're heading into circle using the prism roof as the best way to get there, which gave us the height advantage and it was a power position on the map. Unfortunately we got held by another team until my teammates got downed. I managed to get the res off on one, but then I just decided to try and get out of there. Luckily enough, because they grenaded me, I managed to get away in time, and once I was off the edge of the roof I thought I'd better try and move as quickly as I could into circle. Here I forgot I wasn't running grenades, so I ended up wasting a throwing knife trying to get this guy. He then moves on to the roof of Nova, so I decided to head down to the basement. And at this point, I noticed that my teammates go down. It's me being 17 to 10 different players. And all I'm trying to do is stay around the circle and not make any silly mistakes. Unfortunately, it's not a great pull for me for this circle, and the minimap shows that there's a number of enemies between me and where the circle is going to be. So what I've got to do now is try and move as quickly as possible without getting downed by any enemy players. Luckily again, with the pings on the minimap, I can see that there's a guy on my right in the top of this building, so I managed to take him down, and that's just a bit of good reactions and the TTK of the PPSH, which gets me out of that situation. On the minimap, I can see that the three remaining players are above me on the hill. I tried to use the hill as a bit of cover to get down an ammo box so that I can get my stims and make a gas play. Luckily enough, I get the best possible pull, and that gives me a chance to get into the zone and into cover at the same time.
Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies.
At this point, I can hear that there are enemy players in the room above me. I wait to see whether or not any of them push, but they don't, so I decide to push them. Luckily enough, there's only one in the room when I do so, and I manage to get the down. Once I get the kill, I can see on the minimap that his teammate is now pushing back into the room. I can see that the enemy player in the room above is fighting the enemy player opposite down the stairs. I can tell from the audio that the guy in the room above me is the one that dies, so I push down the stairs. Luckily enough, I managed to get the first shot, and with a little bunny hop, I get a headshot, and I manage to down the enemy player before he downs me, and we get the win.